Rowing isn't for those who fear failure, nor is it for those who like sleep. Sleep is a luxury. Rowing isn't a luxury, nor is it up in big lights. There is only pride for the school you are representing, dedication and the desire to win. We row for the G. The early mornings are a small part of the daily grind as a rower. Physically and mentally, rowing toys with you. Rowing isn't your friend, it doesn't play nice. Because if success is to come at all, those willing to accept success must accept failure and pain. Will Fisher, 2015 captain of boats and first eight rower from 2014 to 2015, was a member of the fastest ever Guildford first eight to date. Fisher also knows exactly what it's like to experience failure and pain, along with the weight of expectations by the school, placed not only on him as a member of the first eight, but also as he was the captain of a boats, a captain of the Guildford Boatshed, on the verge of something special.
In terms of pressure, how much was placed on you as a leader and a member of what is considered the fastest ever first eight Guildford has ever had?
Leading up to the river was probably the most stressful I've been in my life. Like it or not, you're going to cop a bit of pressure from all aspects of the school. I know people were just trying to, you know, give me a few encouraging words, but it just, like, some people didn't know how to go about it. It just made me feel worse, and I was waking up every morning, you know, needing to vomit. I was just so nervous about hitting the river. And being captain of boats, you carry a little bit of extra responsibility because people look towards you, especially the boys. You know, they look towards you for a bit of moral guidance, a bit of support. And I just had to step up that season and try and help the boys after we didn't come off on top. The biggest factor in what makes a winning first aid crew is sharing a common goal. And obviously, you know, you've got let's win out of the river. That's a really simple goal, but it's a simple goal, but to get there, it's really difficult. Everyone's going to be on board. And the thing with rowing is that mental attitude. One rower's got a bad attitude, and that can take it out of the whole crew. I think what makes a winning first aid is to keep cool under pressure. I know that our crew, the 2015 first aid, I don't think we handled the pressure very well. And as you've already mentioned, you know, considered the fastest first aid to come out of Guildford, that's a big weight carrying your shoulders. And such a tight season, and we were so nervous, and I think we just faltered a bit, we just couldn't handle it. So really, the qualities to make a winning first aid are, you've got to have a common goal, you've got to be willing to sacrifice everything for that goal, and most of all, you have to keep your wits about you, just got to keep cool. You can't let it get to you, because there's a lot of factors that are going to try and sway you, and all it takes is one person to be off on the day, and that can really dramatically affect the crew.
Train, guide and win is rowing in a nutshell. Training morning and night, eat, sleep, row, repeat, an endless cycle, a grueling 6 months that is only measured by how hard and how far an athlete wants to pursue greatness. Every 1500 meter skull trial, 2000 meter ergo, 4 minute ergo, an endless amount of time pumping iron, all adds up and is all for one race. When you step into an eight, you evolve into machines, staring straight ahead in the zone, letting nothing get in the way of success. One person who has seen the shed grow is Tony Loveridge. With 23 years at Guildford and a former Scotch old boy, he knows all too well how the PSA place rowing up on a pedestal. Rowers not only train to uphold pride within the school, but also to be the best boat shed in the PSA.
As a coach, Tony, what makes you come back year after year?
Well, most definitely the athletes. That is the main reason. You know, whether it's schoolboy athletes who I'm involved in now or in the past, you know, the club scene. But it's the athletes that, you know, give the enthusiasm to the program and you know, the energy to it. The coach, who really is a guide and supporting the energy from the athletes. So, I enjoy working with the athletes. And students certainly help keep me young and on my toes.
So over the years, Tony, what changes have you seen to the Guildford Boat Shed?
Look, there's been lots of changes. I think one of the big changes has been the number of boys rowing. From when I first started, it was sort of around 70 boys rowing, and now we're sort of just about double that, just short of double, 135, I think, at the last count. So that's a massive change. You know, the program means, you know, a lot more equipment's come into the program, a lot more coaches, and you know, we're sort of really stretched at the moment in the program in terms of, you know, housing the equipment. But you know, they're all good things, and it's a good indicator. You know, the boys are keen and willing, and so that's probably the main change I've seen.
Those who haven't walked in the rower's shoes can try to understand, but those who try to understand really can't fully comprehend the sheer amount of work, dedication and grit involved, especially in schoolboy rowing. Not only does rowing push you mentally and physically every training session, every week, we row because success is never guaranteed. It's the journey. It's the constant adaptation we put our bodies through and strategies we implement to gain a second or two. Each year evolves into another group of boys and another challenge. Because at the end of the day we row for each other, meeting at the end through thick and thin, laying everything down for a roll of the dice. Success is never final, and failure is never fatal. It's courage that counts.